met me before, in fact, everybody knew what I was all about. But now I got to live a certain way because of who I'm married to. I didn't want this call. God didn't call me. He called you.
Hosea gets this woman, he takes her home. He takes her home. And not only do he take her home, he even got the nerve, he started liking her a little bit.
I didn't get you because I was in love with you. I got you because God told me I had to. I didn't get you because you were so cute, so pure, and so fine. I got you because God said I needed to marry you. I got to live with you and not even love you. And I don't even know you, but because God said. So now they're living together. He done started liking her. How do you know he started liking her, Pastor? He started liking her a little bit because he had a baby with her. Let me tell you something about me. Then.
I say after Thursday, come out, I let me tell you this.
But he knew where she came from. He knew what she was. But for some strange reason, when his emotions got involved with her, everything that she ever did in the past didn't matter.
Yeah.
It did not matter. Now he's gonna have children with her. Not one, but two. Not two, but three kids with this woman that he knew. You know, I really don't know if these kids are mine. Because I know what your past looked like. And I'm only with you because God told me to be with you. Now we got kids together. But look, she got tired of being first lady. She got tired of being with him. Why? Because it was too different from what she was used to.
Yeah.
Let me help you right here. Let me help you real quick. See, some of us, we go through stuff and our feelings, our emotions get hurt. And when our feelings and our emotions get hurt, we build what we call a wall.
Uh-huh.
Right?
Uh-huh.
Not realizing that you're the only one that can see the wall.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
And the wall itself is standing in between you and what God wants you to have.
Because
guess what you're doing? This is what you're doing.
That's right.
I'm gonna break up with him because he ain't. Then you be mad when he get with somebody else, and she seems like she happy all over. That's when you want to go around with your little tight clothes on, show up in Cleveland, look what he missed out on. If that's all he missed out on, boom.
There you go.
You gotta stop using your personal assets to get people.
Yeah.
You get that in the name. If it ain't coming from the inside, it don't matter. Am I too real for you? I want to get back to the store. So we all could have been leave church for good. It ain't going back to church.
You
talking
about
Gomer did not know what it felt like to have a good man. Because every man she ever had used her. Every man she ever had abused her. But now this joker done got me and put me in the house and put kids on me. I'm a mother now. Whoa. I didn't ask for that. You said marry you. You ain't say nothing about having no kids. And you expect me to leave everything about myself to raise these kids. No. See, that's why some of us don't want kids now, because we sold into self.
Yeah.
I ain't on my head. If you ain't married, you ain't supposed to be practicing anyway.
Amen.
Oh, God, I didn't read that one. This is demonic act when you do it outside of marriage. That's just the truth. It's ugly, but it's the truth. Having sex before marriage is a demonic act. It's not holy. If it ain't for God, it's against God. Ain't no pretty way to put it. We slept the other night. What Pop say? He said, what if y'all was sleeping? That really happened. It's time to take the cover off of something. We don't want to hear stuff for raw, real what it is, because it hurt our feelings. But it's the truth. At least you know what you're doing.
That's right.
All right? I ain't gonna say that. I'm gonna say it. I'm gonna do it. Nah. It's killing. You better watch. Screaming, oh Jesus. And oh God. And you ain't there. Because if he show up when you say, oh Jesus, oh, what? Y'all know what I'm saying. You got to be careful. You're laughing because I know the truth. Gomer don't know what it feels like to have somebody good. And a lot of us, we mistreat people based off of what we had in the past. We don't give it time to grow. We don't give it time to materialize. We don't give it time to become what it is supposed to become, because we don't know what a good man is. It's amazing how people can tell you what a good woman is and what a good man is, and they ain't never had one. You're telling me what you read in the Bible. Because if what's good to you may not be good to me. That's somebody. So now she decides to leave. Because I ain't comfortable with this. I don't like this good life. This is not what I'm used to. The Bible says she went back out into the street. Went back to the people that she always knew would love her the way she wanted to be loved. She was used to getting stuff. She was used to selling herself for stuff. She was used to doing whatever she had to do to get that Michael Kors bag. She was used to doing whatever she had to do to get that promotion on the job. She was used to doing whatever she had to do to get that gas in her car. She was used to stuff, but now you're sitting there at home with a good holy man, and I got two children by this man that I really don't even want, that I don't know. Let me get back to the area where I'm used to being treated. And see, I can be treated bad because I'm used to it. If you've ever lost weight before, and you lost 25 or 30 pounds, when you go back and pick up 25 or 30 pounds, it's heavy.
Yeah.
But the reason why you didn't know you was carrying that weight, because you got used to carrying it. See, some of us are in bondage and it don't feel like we're in bondage because we've been in bondage for a long time and you don't know what it feels like to be free. That's why some prisoners, when they get out of jail, they got to do something to go back because they don't understand how to live free. I would rather be incarcerated where I know everything going than to live free. So she went back. Jose was like, that's cool, she gone. I'll keep the kids. But in chapter 3, God says, where your woman? The one I told you to marry, where is she? I don't know where she is. I married her like you told me to. You told me to marry her. You tell me I had to stay with her. That ain't in the Bible, I'm just paraphrasing. She gone, Lord. She left me. I didn't leave her. She left me. So it ain't my fault she left. I still got the kids. Does that count for something? He said, no. Go get her. And whatever, however much it cost you to purchase her from her pimp, you pay the price to get her, and you bring her back home.
Yes, Lord.
First of all, I got to marry this woman that I don't like, don't love, and she's a worldly woman. Now I got to pay to get her back. I got to take my life savings to get her back. And then Hosea did exactly what God told him to do. And then God said, see, God has a great way of teaching you a lesson. And a lesson that you will never, ever forget. Why you were taught that lesson. So Hosea began to wonder, why did I have to go through all of that? And God says, now you're able to preach to my people the way I need you to preach to them. He said, because my woman is a whore. My woman, Israel, I brought her out of poverty. I brought her out of slavery. I brought her out of bondage. I put shoes on her feet, put clothes on her back, gave her husbands, gave her children, gave her land. She didn't have to work for nothing, but she wanted everything out there. She even had the nerve to bring children to me that I didn't even bear and expect me to do something about it. I can't have that. So now you got to go preach to them. You got an example with you now. You had to spend all you had to get her back, and she ain't even worth it. But because you love her. See, when you love them, you'll spend whatever you got to spend to get her back. It don't matter what they did. It don't matter. See, Hosea messed around and fell in love with the prostitute. Because now he can preach to the people and say, you need to come back to God because he loves you. You see this woman? You see this woman? I didn't love her at first, and she treated me so bad. But I fell in love with her. And I dare anybody to talk about it.